What's going on, Stop Frying Your Brain? This is John Wallace coming at you from the Palm Springs Street Fair. And I'm about to meet our boy Whispers. We had a little intro for him the other night, Timothy Proctor, a.k.a. Whispers. See, what we're doing, man, is we're trying to meet people in the street that are actually recovering from this thing, and they're actually finding the new solution and the new way of life, man. So one person at a time, man, one step at a time, one thing at a time. Thank you, Aaron, for sharing. I love you, girl. We got Aaron Burnett on here from Florida. Robert the Brain's going to join us from Florida. We're going to put this thing worldwide, enterprise. Let's find a solution, right? So the other night, we got our boy Timothy Proctor doing a little spit game for us. Now we're going to get to know him a little bit better. We're going to walk through our street fair here in Palm Springs. It's gorgeous outside, you know, a little bit muggy, but this is a cool thing they put on every single Thursday night here. So what brought this about is we got this little bit of a talent show thing coming up on the 19th of August, you know, and we're going to broadcast that live. It's going to be at Addiction Therapeutic Services in Rancho Mirage, and unfortunately, Mr. Proctor isn't going to be here to join us for that because he's going back to Florida, so he's going to be in y'all hood. All right, Joe, you know, Aaron, your hood. Robert? The Brain, your hood. So he's coming out there, but before we get to that, I wanted to get to know him a little bit better, you know? So he's meeting me out here at the street fair. In fact, here he is right here. We're going to say what's up and see how he's doing. What's up, brother?
All right.
So let's take a little walk, man. Let's roll and stroll. I got to hold the camera up high because you are tall, dog.
Yes.
And you're standing on the curb, so it came out. How long you been out here in the desert, dog?
I've been out here in the desert for about 60 days.
Right on. Say what's up to Stop Frying Your Brain first. Introduce yourself.
Stop Frying Your Brain. What's up, y'all? How y'all doing?
Right on.
I'm just out here trying to live, you know, do my thing and change my life and get my life right. And since I've been here, it's been glorious.
Right on.
I just want to do what I do, man. God just gave me a blessing, a gift, and I want to share it with you guys. That's all.
Right on. We got Joanna's joining us from London, all the way from London, England, man. Stop Frying Your Brain's a 250,000 community addict and strong and growing, right? We got 6 million uniques on there. We're in 172 countries. And what we're doing, man, is we're trying to find people that are coming at this from a different modality. So if you're in recovery and you got a story to tell, if you want recovery, give us a call. We can find you something like that. So first and foremost, Timothy Whispers, what's your story, man?
Well, my story is that, you know, I had an issue with crack cocaine, and I just decided that I was sick and tired of being sick and tired, and when the pain outweighed the obsession, I said, I need to do something about this, and I rode all the way up to the airport with a crack pipe in my hand. I slammed it on the floor.
Pushing Brillo? You know,
yeah, and I said, that's it. I'm done after that. And right now, I'm clean, man, like 60 days, you know what I'm saying? And I'm saying, damn, this is all right now. This feels great. I'm doing all types of things, and I'm getting my wind back in my sail right now. And I've been performing different places, and that's what I was born to do. And before crack, I did this like 10 years straight. Supporting myself with no job, no nothing. This is all
just your poetry.
Yeah,
just your spoken word stuff, man.
Yeah,
we're gonna get to that, man. I'm gonna get a little further away from the East Coast type of feeling out there.
Yeah.
Speaking of East Coast type of feeling, I know Alabama's not quite there, but what's up, Tracy? How you doing, girl? Love you.
How you doing, Tracy? I love you too. The way in London.
Yeah, no. Joanna's in London. Tracy's in Alabama. Oh, wow. We got Aaron in Florida. We're in 172 countries.
Wow.
We got three servers across this place, man. We got different platforms. We got the recovery chicks in the house, man.
Wow.
Who else we got, man? We got Recovery Army. Let me think. We got everybody, man. We got the Detox Channel. We got the Sober Living Channel. Man, love you, Tracy. Love you all, man. I love our Stop Frying the Brain people, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So what's your plan from here, man? You're not going to be able to be here for the talent show, man. You're going to be able to lay it down there.
My plan from here is to go home, take care of some legalities. Get my car.
Some legalities.
Yeah.
I know what that means.
Yeah. And get in my car and drive across the state right back here.
Right, really?
And, yes. And
Holy Spirit Recovery, that's the one, man.
Yeah, definitely.
That's the one. And the Brain's watching. Say what's up to Robert Hensley.
What's up, Robert Hensley?
Yeah, you guys spoke on the phone yesterday, the day before, I believe that, man. That's the brain behind the whole operation there.
Definitely.
Yep. We're coming at you from Palm Springs Street Fair, man. They have this every single Thursday night. It's going to get more crowded as we get moving on here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they got all... I mean, the amount of stuff they got at the street fair is crazy. This boy right here, this dude right here with the merengue and the CBD... He's cool as shit, man. I don't know if you ever tried that stuff.
No, I never tried that.
CBD is good stuff, man. CBD is good stuff. Oh, so we got to hear a little bit of Quick Spit here from Timothy the other night, you know, and since he's not gonna be here for the 19th for that big showcase we're doing, he's gonna watch it live though, right?
Oh yeah.
Definitely. You think he can make it back here by the 19th?
I don't think so, because that's a long drive across the state.
And those legalities might jam you up a little bit.
No, not at all. You know what I'm saying? I just gotta turn
recovery in some, checks.
Just gotta turn in a couple of community service hour sheets. I got them and I've done it already. So all I gotta do is turn them in.
All right, that's right. So I check this out, man. I set up trying to video visit with my homegirl that's in jail right now. She's about to get out. We're about to bring her up here and get her some help, you know, because she's actually taking recovery. But I'm not allowed on the facility grounds, man. I found that out. Why? I got a background.
Okay.
A bit of a background. And so I accidentally made my appointment to see them live, like actually show up to the facility. Wow. Now I know they're not gonna let me do that, but I was trying to do it. Now they got this cool app where you can visit people in jail from your smartphone.
Yes, you can.
That's crazy, man.
Yes, it is.
So I've been writing her every day about recovery, and she's been offered treatment. She's been offered help a whole bunch of times. This is the first time she reached back, you know?
Yeah, man. Definitely.
This is the first time she reached back, you know, so I'm blessed, man.
Don't feel bad, man. I got 16 felonies, and I'm still walking on courtroom tactics.
Yeah. You know? Well, the reason they deny me, I'm still in security threat group. I still provide a threat to the institution. I ain't been locked up in a long time, man. And I still provide a threat to it.
Kind of, I remember that. I remember I got pulled over for a traffic stop, and they brought the SWAT team.
Yeah. A helicopter pulls up, man. Yeah. That's my boy Tab. We'll meet him, so hopefully real soon, man. He gets pulled over for, I think he had a blinker out, and a helicopter came up above him, man.
Wow.
Yeah. So hey, this is a cool little drop by. Let's hear a little bit of poetry, man. You ready for that?
No doubt.
Yeah, we're gonna try to find a microphone, but you just gotta be a little bit louder. I'm loud as shit, man. Nobody wants me with a microphone.
Oh yeah. I like this right here.
Right here?
Yeah.
Now you gotta make sure you can see you in there, cause it's...
Yeah, I think I can see me. I think I wanna take my shades off.
All right.
Yeah, cause I'm getting old now, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Oh, age plus drugs, you know what I'm saying? It takes away a lot from you.
Yeah.
Let me see. They say that lightning travels at 90,000 miles per hour, which is half the speed of light. Now imagine that twice, which would be the speed of crack smoke through glass pipes destroying life. And the sacrifice is great, and it's always traded mistakes for personal earthquakes that shake so hard your mental Richter scale is broken. Leaving your mental earth wide open. So prepare for the countdown, because it's about to rain on your parade. There's no sun to create shade, and the darkness cuts like razor blades, and situations, boom, blow up like hand grenades, and you wonder to yourself, how did I get AIDS? See, this one ripped the seams in you, letting out the fiend in you, and I can hear that scream in you, but it's only worse if you can't hear it first, so some of us stick cotton in our ears so we can't hear, so for years it appears that we're deaf, until our family members give their tears to death, or we reach that youngster who have none left, whose only mission is to enter the winter, and in the school he's a no-show with no snowstorm, he thinks ice keeps him warm, his destruction is long-winded, he's literally descending, pending life on the world's racetrack, he's been speeding for 10 years and trying to get first place. Back, but he's been speeding for 10 years and still the checkered flag is not there. Maybe it's because his engine got hot, or he stayed too long in the pit stop, listening to others whiz past while getting gas. Smoke is still filling the glass. See, your bad habits will make you a rabbit in this race, but you will want to be a turtle through these hurdles at a steady pace. And it's divine to let your light shine, which is half the speed of lightning in a shower. So if you find yourself smoking at 360,000 miles per hour and your pipes malfunction, you have regulated the speed of destruction.
Yeah, dog. That's right, man. That's right, man. So what's cool here, man, is I'm sweating like a dog out in this.
Me seat. Too.
And so I'm looking at this little thing right here, and when I first started seeing that, I thought maybe I'm the only three people there. Nah, I'll show you when we're done, dude. I did this little thing this morning because I was excited. I woke up excited. Yeah. I wake up shot out of a cannon, man. Let me come on this side, because there we go. That way I don't feel so short, dog. you know, like Rocky, when Sylvester Stallone has to fight Dolph Lundgren, Sylvester Stallone's like 5'2".
Oh, yeah.
That's what we were using camera tricks, so I look big. Man, so you came out here to the Coachella Valley, to the rehab mecca of the world out here to get well.
That's right.
How'd that work?
This is what I do for work.
How did that work? Find what you were looking for here?
I kept calling the recovery hotline, and in the midst of me in my insanity getting high, and I remember sitting on the beach with a crack pipe in my hand, and I was calling, and I reached this young lady, and she says, "Well, do you have any insurance?" I said, "No." She said, "Well, I'll see what I can do for you." So about a week or two passed, and I'm driving through the drive-thru at Checkers, and she calls me and she says, hey, guess what? I said, what? An anonymous donor donated $30,000 for your insurance. And I began to cry. So I didn't know whether to hand the girl in the window my crack pipe or my money for my food. But, you know, of course, I'm an addict. I ain't handing my crack pipe. I handed her the money and hauled ass. And I cried all the way home. And I kept calling. I was supposed to be here since February. And I got locked up again. And I called her, and she said, don't worry, you're still on the list. And she sent a letter to my judge. They let me go. I got locked up again, and she kept me on the list. And, you know, I got out, and maybe about 2 weeks after that, I was sitting there crying, and I think I had about 3 rocks left. And she called and said, pack your shit and go to the airport. You're leaving on Delta. And I just threw a bunch of shit in the suitcase, and I came. I didn't ask what, I didn't know what the hell I was packing.
Got some drawers and some socks.
Just grabbed some drawers, some socks, a couple of pairs of shorts and jeans, and took off. And I've been here ever since, and it's gotten greater and greater and greater and greater. And the difference is today is that I'm not playing recovery. I know the lingo. I know how to say that fly shit.
The handshakes.
If you think that I got so many years clean and I ain't got shit.
I know that today, game.
Today, I'm working with a temporary sponsor.
Let's dip in here. Let's get out of this heat for a second.
Working with a temporary sponsor and doing what I need to do and going to meetings. And I'm looking at all this eye candy of potential women. And I can't help myself.
Recovery because, chicks, what's up? Yes. He's on the market.
Yes, definitely. Because that's crazy. But I'm with somebody right now. You know.
Oh, now you're in trouble now.
Yeah.
Now you're in trouble now.
I am. You know, I got to keep it 100, but I also got to keep it 100 that I'm a man and I can see.
Yeah.
It's not about them.
My eyes will look, man.
They got to get recovery. It's okay to look at the menu, but go home for dinner.
That's right. So, like, check it out. I was at this convention, and I took a couple pictures there and stuff like that. We weren't quite doing this live thing. And I was at this convention, and I sit down because there was a spot to plug my phone in. Like it just told me, it's about to die. So we're going to go until it dies tonight, all right? So if I don't say goodbye, I love you. Goodbye. Stop frying your brain.
Yeah.
All right? So we're at this convention, and I sit down to plug my phone in, and this guy's sitting next to me, and he says, you want to hear a poem? And I'm like, oh, man, again? You know, another one of these? And this guy comes at it with some realness, and I was like, wow, man, wow, that's a message, man. That's a message I could hear. That's a message I could hear, especially when I'm blinded still by my, and still in the cloud and still in the haze, you know? That's a message I could hear. Check this place out. You been in here before?
Oh, no, but this is beautiful.
Yeah, I've been in here before.
It should be my house.
If I would have kept half the money I spent on dope, this would be my house.
Yes.
Luckily, we've been in here before, though. How haven't we stopped frying your brain? So what you were just saying about getting your about getting that scholarship is what that's called. When somebody donates that money, it's Stop Frying Your Brain. We give out 4 of those. We got 4 of those next month. We got a lot of other people coming on to give those to us. Because what I'm about is, man, I don't care about what the front of your insurance card looks like or the back of it or your eye or any of that stuff. If you want help, you pick up the phone, you call us, 760-980-4928. That's my number. Call Michelle, 310-968-0993. That's her number. Click on the site, get Robert's number. It's all over the place. I can't remember it. It's a 772 number.
Yes, it is hotter than a witch's tit in the iron bra.
Yeah, man, let me tell you.
We're going to be all right, though.
We're going to be all right. But let's see if we can't set this thing down. I hate holding on to it. Oh, my boss would straight kill me, though, if I switch it around, man. He already has to go through, I'll keep holding it. He already has to go through, jumps through hoops. And he loves talking to me. But when he's got to listen to me for like 12, 13 hours of me talking, because he wants to edit these things, it gets a little tedious. So basically, what drew me to this dude right here is, you got a different way of coming out a message, man.
Oh, yeah.
You got a way that other people are going to be able to hear, you know? Mm-hmm. So I want to enable you as best we can to stop frying your brain. We want to enable you as best we can to get that message out there in a language that some people might be able to hear, you know? In a language that, you know, when you're in the haze and you're foggy and you're dusted and disgusted and you can't think of anything else other than how am I going to get through this day? You can't imagine a life with it. You can't imagine a life without it.
You know? I just want to say that if you don't believe in a power greater than yourself, find one. If it's a doorknob and that doorknob gives you peace, pray to it every day. Because without a power greater than yourself, you're not going to make it in this recovery zone. I got a piece called Armageddon.
You want to do that one?
I want to share that with you guys.
Hey, let's go over here. Let's go. Let's get a cool little backdrop for it. Let's go inside of the stage down here. I love being able to do this, man, because it used to be back in the day you needed the whole news crew. You needed cameras. You needed the crew. You needed the van. You needed the satellite dish. Now all you need to get your message out there is a smartphone and a little bit of jab. Here's your stage, dog. Let's see it.
I was born by the river in a little tent. And just like the river, I've been flowing ever since. It's been too hard to live in, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there in the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know change gon' come.
See, the day's gon' come when the sun don't shine, and time, it'll stand still, and the rain, it won't fall at all. And your car's just stalled. What's next? There's no contact with your friends and family via text. And those emails, they fail to reach city to city. No electricity, simplicity is obsolete. And the sickness is at its thickest. Here's where we all addicts need something to believe in. See? Atheists, they can't take it. And those pool pimps are really limping because their game was lame. Things ain't the same. There's no clubs, no shows, no late night hoes. Ain't that something when your Mercedes-Benz means absolutely nothing? Only that your faith is misplaced. We said that we're trying to live, but none of us ever been alive. But thank God we just survived. And oh, how I'm satisfied with eating and breathing, but the world that demands so much more. Well, it's too late for amends. We all should have been trusting him. Oh, now you believe because you need in the world that's nothing to offer. Now you're looking for miracle pillows to make the blow softer. Did you ever wonder where you were heading? If you didn't know, it's Armageddon. The end, period, and you can't stand it. Damn it! Lights out on this little planet. They said that the sky's the limit, but there's footprints on the moon, which tells me somebody knew that we were doomed, and it's coming soon. Sooner than we think, that's why we had to hurry up, Lord, and write this poem before I ran out of ink. Hoping that the next civilization to find this message safe and not make the same mistakes, I tell them all. Stay away from those computers and cell phones, because God never sent me a text, but I read his text, and the texture of his word is comforting, like, wow. A savior in paraphrases, like what I'm spitting was already written. God's message has been hidden, and religion, that's the cause of most wars. But we blamed him for the boundaries that we created in the first place. So it really doesn't matter what line was crossed. We are all crisscrossed with crosses to bear. Jesus carried his, so if yours is heavy, why should I care? But it's that same type of thinking that got the lights of this world flickering. We as people will continue bickering until the lights go out.
Change gon' come.
Peace.
That's right, Stop Frying Your Brain, man. This dude's a G, y'all. This guy, that's the real business right there. Ain't no doubt about it. Ain't no doubt about it. Ain't no doubt about it in my mind, man. I keep getting calls from somebody here that's really, really trying to get a hold of me, and I don't care, dog. I better hang out with Whispers here, man.
Right.
Listen, man, if you out there and you need some help, we can help you. Pick up your phone, man. Don't sit there busted and disgusted and rest inside of that bullshit no more. We do recover. We do get better. We do stand up. And when we do, we shine. And there ain't no doubt about that. You can see it in the chain on this man's chest, man.
Oh,
we
yeah.
Get up and we move.
Yes.
And we get our feet moving, because as addicts, we can only do one of two things. We can either get better or we can get worse. So which one do you want to do today? You want to get better today? Then give us a call. We'll help you out, man. We'll find you a way. If you're replacing, if you're putting out there some kind of new treatment, some new modality, something that's fluid, man. I've been talking a lot lately about the busted and disgusted, an industry that is broken at its core, that is not doing what it should be doing, and it's being paid trillions, but I don't want to think about that negative no more. I want to find you, the addict. That's who I'm here for. That's what I am. That's what he is, and that's why we're here. I got a feeling you're going to be seeing a lot more of this man,
yeah.
A lot more of this man, because he's got some real talent, a real message, and we got to get it out there. We got to reach as many as we can, because I realize going into meetings and talking and sharing and getting a podium only had me a limited audience, and this disease is too big for that. It's so powerful, it takes a god to defeat. A god, and even that god can only do it one day at a time. So if today is the day that you want recovery, pick up your phone and call us. Stop sitting and resting in that BS. It ain't gonna get you nowhere. I love you, dog, man.
Love
I know
too,
I just
bro.
Met you, but I love you like my brother from another mother right here. I almost got a little misty and shit. I got something in my eye. All right, say your goodbyes.
Yo, peace. Y'all remember, one day at a time, 1 second at a time, 1 minute, whatever you need to get yourself together. But there is no answer in picking up drinking, thinking, sinking. And the dangerous, most dangerous place in this world is right here, between these two ears. So, stay up.
Deadliest, scariest prison I ever been through is between my two ears. Listen, stop frying your brain, team. I love you. Thank you all for coming
stop
on here and sharing. Joanna, Aaron, Robert, Tracy, everybody that got on here and watched this and listened to this, please share this and get this out there and get this message real. We can help, man. But you got to be willing to help yourself first, all right? I love you, everybody, and I got to go because I got 5% left and somebody might need a call from me.
Sing it. A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
We will rock you.
Sing it!
We will rock you.
Buddy, you're an old man, poor man, pleading with your eyes, gonna make you zombie someday. You got mud on your face, big disgrace. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will.